Good evening and welcome to our second live coverage of the American Football Championship of the World, Super Bowl 18. Now, a better matchup of teams we couldn't have hoped for, and it's going to be a live four-hour spectacle from Tampa Stadium here in Tampa Bay, Florida. Currently the two best teams in America, these squads are two powerhouse teams that use their speed, skill, and above all, physical intimidations to batter and maul their opponents, and that's no exaggeration. But to get a better idea of what this game and this particular Super Bowl means to the American psyche, I'd like to join and get our views from my colleague Nicky Horn on the matter.
Miles, thank you very much. Good evening and welcome. Well, Super Bowl, of course, is unique. It's America's spectacle, born and bred here in the United States. Independence Day is as American as Super Bowl. After all, the fireworks set off every July the 4th were invented by the Chinese long before the Americans won their independence. Not even the inauguration of a president is as American as Super Bowl. That is a pale imitation of a coronation of a king or a queen. And each Super Bowl is designated Roman numerals. Who gets those? Well, kings, queens, popes, and wars get Roman numerals. And it's going to be a war out there in a few minutes. Now, one man who has a unique insight into the playing of these wars and the winning is our guest today. Last year, he coached his team, the Miami Dolphins, to the Super Bowl against the Washington Redskins. He holds with Tom Landry the record for most Super Bowl appearances, five in fact. It's indeed a pleasure to welcome to our Channel 4 booth here, Don Shula. Don, welcome. Thank you very much indeed for joining us. All the commentators, and Mars was saying earlier, that this really is going to be the Super Bowl of Super Bowls. Do you think that what we're about to see is the best against the best?
I think so, Nicky, without a doubt. These two teams have proved that they belong here. The Washington Redskins, now over a period of about 3 years, have had the best record in professional football. And this year, they completely took apart the Dallas Cowboys in a key game and then went on to sweep the playoffs. And they have the best record in the National Football Conference and the best record in all of football. The Raiders, on the other hand, tied with us, the Miami Dolphins, for the best record in the American Football Conference. But we lost to Seattle in the playoffs, and the Raiders beat Seattle, and that's the reason that they're here today. And I believe, is going to be the finest Super Bowl. You never know how a game is going to unfold and what's going to happen. But these teams certainly are healthy, they're capable of the big plays, and I'm all set and ready to go.
Now, the thing is, it was raining here yesterday. It's now cloudy and the ground is dry. Do you think the ground favors either team?
Well, this is going to be a fast field, a fast pitch, or a fast track, whatever it is. And whenever you have a fast field, then I think both teams are going to be able to take advantage of it. But when you get the muddy field, if it rains later or it rained earlier in the week, then I think the Redskins would be favored because they've got Riggins, the big strong back, the big strong line. But on a fast field, there's no question in my mind that both teams are going to be able to play their best football. And that's what it should be. On a day like today, you wouldn't want the field, the elements, the conditions, the weather conditions to enter into the final score, and they won't today.
Okay, Coach, thank you for joining us. Miles, back to you.
Well, before we go on bringing you the show, I'd like to take this opportunity to thank all of you loyal fans who've been with us throughout the season. Welcome any new fans who have joined us tonight for this spectacular match. And it is for the benefit of these new fans that we take this opportunity to again put together a short explanation of the rules so that you may hope to benefit and enjoy what many American football fans in the United States consider potentially best Super Bowl ever.
What we're going to do is take you through an actual series of plays from Washington Redskins game earlier this year and show you just how a team makes progress up the field, ending with a score. As we freeze in action, the Washington offense in red have the ball on their 30-yard line. They're playing from left to right.
Washington have four attempts known as downs to gain a total of at least 10 yards and retain possession. This is the first of those four attempts. They are, of course, still 10 yards to go. This is known as first and 10.
Washington can move the ball by running with it, passing it. Let's see what happens.
In fact, they run with it. The quarterback hands off the ball to his running back, who gains 4 yards before being tackled. Again, 4 yards, sit left to go, second down coming up.
So, 7-6.
Again, this ends from the ball. Another gain of 4 yards by number 44, John Riggins.
So now it's 8 yard gain total, two left, and it's third down.
This time, Washington passes. Quarterback Joe Fosman drops back and prepares to throw.
As his receivers set off downfield, there are three possible outcomes. One, a Washington player catches the pass, the play would be complete, and the Redskins retain possession. Two, a defender from the opposition catches the ball, an interception, and they take over possession. Three,
No one catch the ball. That's called incomplete. Washington retained possession, no yards gained, the down is wasted, and they have to try again.
Perfect pass to a Washington wide receiver. A good catch. The Redskins have easily gained their objective. 10 yards or more, and they're still in possession.
Washington starts another series of four downs. They've moved up to the opposition's 40-yard line and are in scoring position. First attending.
Washington immediately goes for pass. And it's to be perfect again. A clean catch, a sprint to the end zone, a classic example of the effective of the game, a touchdown, 6 points.
After a touchdown, another point can be scored by successfully kicking a conversion. We'll see that often enough tonight. If after a few downs the team isn't in range of scoring a touchdown, they'll attempt to kick the ball between the posts, a field goal, and 3 points.
So you see, it's not that difficult now in our preview program. Coach, you look the Raiders to win today. Miles, what's your prediction? What do you think?
Hey, Nick, as I said before, Super Bowl is great, but in particular, this was a super match. Currently, the two best teams in the league. Now, when you discuss these teams, superlatives abound. Great coaching, great personnel, super offenses, high scoring, and when you consider the defense, mean, lean, and fast. Contrast the style of the Redskins and watch the good guys against the LA Raiders in dark uniforms, and they living every moment of being the bad guys. But if I have to choose, I go 1 point for Raiders, Nicky.
All right, Miles, thank you. I still stick with the Redskins. So it's a Super Bowl day here at Tampa. And for this day at least, Tampa Bay become the center of the sporting universe. Stay with us on Channel 4 for Super Bowl 18.
Hi, I'm Joe Theismann, quarterback of the world champion Washington Redskins, inviting you to join the Washington Redskins and the Los Angeles Raiders on Channel 4.
Welcome. It's Super Bowl 18, live from Tampa Bay, Florida. We're waiting for teams to come out and join our CBS commentators, Pat Summerall and John Madden. It should be any minute now the teams come out on stage. And listen to that crowd, 72,000 people here at the Tampa Stadium.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing the defensive unit of champions of National Football Conference, the Washington Redskins. Number 79, the left end, Todd Liebenstein. Left tackle, number 65, Dave Butch. And right tackle, number 77, Merrill Grant. Right end, number 72, Dexter Manley. Left linebacker, number 55, Mel Putman. The middle linebacker, number 52, Neil Olkowitz. Right linebacker, number 57, Rich Mott. The left cornerback, number 28, Darrell Green. Right cornerback, number 24, Anthony Washington. Strong safety, number 48, Ken Coffey. And the free safety, number 29, Mark Murphy. Coach Phil Gibbs and the rest of the Washington Redskins. Champions of the AFC, the Los Angeles Raiders. Number 21, wide receiver Cliff Branch. Number 79, left tackle Bruce Davis. At guard, number 73, Charlie Hinna. 50, Dave Dolby. At right guard, number 65, Mickey Marvin.
Let's go! Let's go, buddy!
At right tackle, number 70, Henry Lawrence. The tight end, number 46, Todd Tippen. Wide receiver, number 80, Malcolm Barnwell. The quarterback, number 16, Jim Lunkett. At running back, number 32, Marcus Allen. And at running back, number 33, Kay King. Oh, Tom Glories and the rest of Los Angeles Raiders.
Talking to everybody in Great Britain. It's great that y'all had a chance to follow us this year. It was a great part of for us to be part of your football. And we hope that you can keep following us here on Channel 4.
I'm Tom Flores, coach of the Los Angeles Raiders, and I'd like to welcome you to Super Bowl Sunday. It should be a great game. We're looking forward to it, and I hope we don't keep you up too late. But whatever happens, I hope we win, and I hope you enjoy the game.
Well, the two coaches there. Don, how do you compare Flores and Gibbs? They have different styles, don't they?
It's interesting that both coaches won the only Super Bowl that they've been. Gibbs won last year, and Flores won a couple of years ago. They have different styles. Flores still plays the two backs, more of the old-fashioned type of game. And on the other hand, Gibbs has put in a one-back offense, and he has done a lot of things with variations and trick plays. So Flores more conservative, Gibbs more wide.
Let's now go back to CBS.
Super Bowl 18, a matchup between, I think without question, the two best teams in the National Football League. Perhaps the first time in the history of this great event it has ever happened. Now, down to PA announcer Mike Mendez.
Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for a moment of silence in memory of Papa Bear George Hallis of the Chicago Bears, founder, father, and patriarch of the National Football League, passed away this season. Thank you. We ask you to remain standing for the presentation of color by the McGill Air Force Peace Color Guard. We also direct your attention to the skies above stadium at the conclusion of our ceremony for a special Super Bowl flyover routine by the 56th Tactical Training Wing from McGill Air Force Base. And now, Honor America, please join recording star Barry Manilow in singing our national anthem.
The land of
Barry Manilow singing the national anthem and the fly pass. Well, early today we met an old friend to the American football program, a man who joined us for a couple of shows early on, Mick Luckhurst of the Atlanta Falcons.
So Mick, the $64,000 question, who's going to win?
Well, in earlier programs you heard me predict that the Washington Redskins were going to take in the Super Bowl over Miami with the Raiders as a dark horse. I now see it as the Raiders looking a little better, maybe a light-colored horse, and I take the Raiders by maybe 7 points. And I believe the main factors are going to be quarterbacks and kickers with a secondary coming in. Obviously, Mosley going to be very important today after missing four or five. And Redskins' secondary has also been beaten a few times. Raiders by seven.
Well, that's interesting analysis from my friend Mick Luckhurst. And when you compare these two teams, they're very evenly balanced. We've already talked about the coaches, both brilliant statisticians and tacticians in American football. Let's move quickly to the quarterback, Heisman MVP this year, going like gangbusters. Opposite him is Jim Plunkett, a veteran looking to go out in a blaze of glory, capable of making a lot of big plays. Move quickly down to running backs. Everybody's zero up day, John Riggins. I mean, we're going to say about him. Scored 13 second touchdowns this year. 24 is another record. Opposite him, sophomore running back, Marcus Allen. Heck of a player that didn't play when the Raiders played up in Washington, D.C. The big key will be, though, whether the defense of the Raiders can stop John Riggins. If that happens, then, as everyone agrees, it's the Raiders by 1 to 7 points.
After millions of spoken and written words and thousands of cocktail parties, we're about to begin. The coin will be tossed to begin the ceremonies by Pro Football Hall of Fame member Bronco Nagurski.